In this video, I will show you how to upload an email generated by the Postcards app to services like Mailchimp. I will show a Mailchimp example, but you can use other email marketing software because all these types of services have the same upload functionality. Okay, let's start. For this tutorial, I will use the same HTML newsletter that I exported from the Postcards app and modified in my previous tutorial. So, this is our newsletter. Now, I have to change the unsubscribe button and insert the unsubscribe tag provided by Mailchimp. It's an important step because all email marketing software require use of an unsubscribe button and URL into your newsletter. Open the index.html file in a code editor and search the URL for the unsubscribe button. The button is located in footer, so I will scroll right to this module. Okay, it is here, and here I will insert the Mailchimp unsubscribe tag. You can find the unsubscribe tag on Mailchimp website. Here it is. I will copy, paste this tag to my URL button and save the file. Here on this page, you will find more information about the use of tags. The unsubscribe button is ready and meets the requirements. Now, let's create an email campaign on Mailchimp. Type the campaign name. Select recipients. I have created a list for this tutorial. Edit the subject of our email and click Save. Now, the most important step of our tutorial, uploading the email. Click Design Email and choose Code Your Own. We'll import our email from the zip file. Because we have the newsletter ready-made, and we should just upload it to Mailchimp without making other changes. I will create an archive with my newsletter and click Import from Zip on Mailchimp. I select my archive and click the Upload button. You can see the archive was uploaded and we have the newsletter on the left side of our browser and the code of our newsletter at the right side of our browser. I want to see how my newsletter looks on desktop and mobile devices. Open Mailchimp and check the desktop version of my newsletter and the mobile version. I think it looks good, and we can continue. Now, I want to send a test email to check it on my desktop and mobile device. The email is sent, and now I can open Gmail to check it. Yes, the email is here, and it looks good. Exactly how it looks in the HTML version and on the Postcards app. The unsubscribe button looks good. The images, social media icons, the entire email content looks good. I want to do one more test in my Outlook app. The email is here, and it looks good. Now I want to check this email on my mobile device. In my case, an iPhone 6S. I think it looks good for the size of my device. You can see this now. On the smaller devices, which have a size less than 620 pixels wide, the email will be responsively resized. I will show you how this looks. For this, I will use an online service for testing emails on different devices. I have sent the same email to this service, and here are the results. Let's check mobile devices first. For example, on iPad Air, looks very good. The next one, let's choose the iPhone 10. The same, looks good on responsive size. Now choose the iPhone 7. Very good as well. Who uses the iPhone SE? Okay, anyway, let's see. Very good. I will check the email on more devices right now, and you will see the results. Also, I want to check desktop versions of my newsletter on different browsers and clients. I will choose a few of these results. You can see. The email looks great on all of these email clients and browsers. I have finished testing and can send my newsletter to subscribers. Don't worry about how your email will look when you create it in using the Postcards app. It will have exactly the same look on the Postcards application and in your browser. In the next video, I will show you how to work with a self-hosted email marketing solution and how our email looks in these applications.